Patients may be seen sleeping in the corridor outside a classroom or on the pavement because they are so desperate to get some shut-eye. It's common for patients to be woken or stopped from sleeping, which causes them to be angry or hostile. Kleine Levin syndrome. An extremely uncommon sleep condition known as Kleine Levin syndrome or KLS, which is also known as recurring hypersomnia, is characterized by recurrent periods of severe hypersomnia that are accompanied by cognitive and behavioral abnormalities such as derealization and apathy. A few days to a few weeks pass between episodes, which are then followed by weeks or months of regular sleep and behavior. In addition to KLS, narcolepsy types 1 and 2, as well as idiopathic hypersomnia, are all classified as central diseases of hypersomnia. Clinical presentation. There is a median age when KLS starts that is 16 years old. Around 80% of patients show up in their second decade, with a range of 4 to 82 years old. Early onset, before 12 years old, is linked to more frequent episodes, while late onset, after 35 years old, is linked to longer episodes. Hypersomnia. KLS must be diagnosed with hypersomnia as a primary clinical symptom. It is important to distinguish hypersomnia from signs of exhaustion or poor energy. During episodes, sleep is greatly enhanced, with a median total sleep duration of 18 hours per day, sometimes with a breakdown of the usual circadian rhythm. Patients may be seen sleeping in the corridor outside a classroom or on the pavement because they are so desperate to get some shut-eye. It's common for patients to be woken or stopped from sleeping, which causes them to be angry or hostile. At the conclusion of an episode of insomnia, there is often a short period of insomnia. Euphoria is a possible side effect of this kind of insomnia. There are many ways to explain the sensation, but one patient defined it thusly: "During this episode, all I want to do is remain awake and do the tasks that I was unable to complete before. It also seems like I have a new lease of life." During later episodes, the urge for sleep and the amount of time spent sleeping decrease. Cognitive disturbance. Hypersomnia is the most prevalent symptom, although cognitive problems are not far behind. During episodes, the vast majority of patients have trouble reading and speaking. More than two-thirds of patients report abnormal, labored speech. There may be a lack of spontaneous speech, monosyllabic or short phrases, a restricted vocabulary, and slurred, garbled, incomprehensible, or juvenile stereotype language among the signs and symptoms of this disease. The validity of cognitive and memory tests during a KLS episode has been questioned since patients might be reluctant, irritated, tired, and inattentive, making them difficult to administer. Derealization. Uncertainty about reality is a frequent and maybe the most particular sign of the disorder during an episode. The environment seems to be warped, untrue, or distorted. It might be difficult to tell whether something is real or not based on how we see it. Things and people seem far away, and one patient even noticed that his own voice sounded different to him. Apathy. More than 90% of KLS patients describe apathy as a primary and regular symptom, frequently to the point of frankabulia. All kinds of activities, including reading, watching TV, using mobile phones, and engaging in any kind of social interaction are reported to be lacking in self-motivation by patients and their loved ones. A whopping 80% of patients ignore their personal hygiene when they're sick. Change in eating behaviors. The majority of patients have had at least one episode of binge eating. Megaphagia is a condition that affects around two-thirds of individuals. At each meal, the patient seems to consume a large amounts of food. Unrestrained eating typically focuses on certain flavors, such as sweet or salty or sour, even though they are uncharacteristic meal choices for the person. Hypersexuality. About half of men and one-third of women experience at least one episode of hypersexuality. Hypersexuality is not uncommon in prepubescent boys and girls. These include increased masturbation and a variety of improper sexual habits, such as masturbating in the presence of parents and therapists, masturbating in the middle of the night in front of a mirror, or masturbating while in the presence of other people. In spite of the fact that hypersexuality is often cited as an important sign of KLS, it is likely just one feature of the disinhibition that is typical of KLS episodes. Disinhibition of a more general kind is more prevalent. If you find this video helpful, please hit the subscribe and bell buttons. And don't forget to like and share this video. Thanks.